Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a powerful, dark, fiery text effect ablaze with flames from behind. Before we begin, I want to point out that you can follow most of this tutorial if you're using Photoshop version CS2 or later. However, the last step requires version CC 2014.2 or later in order to use the flame filter. If you're using an earlier version and would still like to add flames, you can refer to another tutorial that I did in which I used a photo of actual flames. I placed that tutorial's link in my video's description, as well as the link to the flame file. I'll be moving a bit faster for more advanced users. I provided this texture that you can download so you can follow along. Its link is located in my video's description or project files below. You can also use your own texture if you like. Just make sure that its height is approximately 800 pixels, and its resolution is 150 pixels per inch in order to get similar results as mine. Unlock the background and make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Hide the copy and make the bottom background active. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Levels. In the Output Highlight Level field, type in 190. Click the New Layer icon and change its blend mode to Color. Click the Foreground Color to open the Color Picker. In the Hexadecimal field, type in FDA212. Then, click OK or press Enter or Return. Open your Brush Tool and Brush Preset Picker. Make the size 1100 pixels, the hardness 0%, and the opacity and flow 100%. Go to the center and click once. Make a new layer. We'll fill it with black by pressing Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open the Fill window. Open the Contents list and click Black. Open your Eraser tool and the Brush Preset Picker. Make its size 800 pixels and the hardness 0%. Go to the center and click once. Change its blend mode to overlay and reduce its opacity to 70%. To save space in the Layers panel, let's place all the layers that comprise the background into a folder. To do this, scroll to the bottom layer and shift-click it to make it and all the layers in between active. Then, press Ctrl or Command G. Let's name the folder Background. Invert your foreground and background colors by pressing X on your keyboard. Open your Type tool and pick a thick, heavy font. I'm using Geomancy Extra Bold. I provided its link if you'd like to use it. I'll make its size 327 points. However, feel free to adjust the size, but keep in mind the finished result will look best if your text is large. I'll make its aliasing sharp and the alignment centered. Click on your document and type out your text. To adjust the space between characters, click between them and press Alt or Option and the left or right arrow key on your keyboard. To center the text on your document, open your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A to select your canvas. Click the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. Then deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Next, we'll convert our text into a smart object so we can adjust the layer styles at any time, as well as replace our text with another without having to redo the effects. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Make the texture visible and active. We're going to show the texture through our text by making it into a clipping mask. Press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac. Make your text active and click the FX icon. Click Drop Shadow. The blend mode is Multiply, the color is black, and the opacity is 90%. Check Use Global Light. The angle is 130 degrees. The distance and size are 20 pixels. And the spread is 0. Click Outer Glow. The blend mode is Color Burn. The opacity is 15%. And the color is black. The technique is softer, the spread is 0, the size is 50 pixels, and the range is 50%. Click Inner Glow. The blend mode is Color Burn, the opacity is 30%, and for the color, pick a bright red. The source is Edge. The choke is 0, the size is 20 pixels, and the range is 50%. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is Inner Bevel, the technique is Chisel Hard, and the depth is 1000%. The direction is up, the size is 8 pixels, and soften it 0 pixels. Global light is checked. The angle is 130 degrees, and the altitude is 48 degrees. The highlight color is a bright orange. Its hexadecimal numbers in the color picker window are FFA312. The highlight mode is screen, and the opacity is 100%. The shadow color is black. Its blend mode is Multiply, and its opacity is 85%. Click Contour. Open the Contour preset list and click the gear icon. Click Small List. I'm choosing Sawtooth 2, however, feel free to experiment with other contour presets. Since our text has some dimension, its texture should be slightly offset from the background's texture. I'll shift-click the texture to make it active as well. However, if you only want to enlarge the texture inside the text, make only the texture active. Open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag the Transform's bounding box out. Then press Enter or Return. Let's collapse the effects to save space in the Layers panel. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Levels. Clip it to the texture by either pressing the same keystrokes as before or clicking the Clipping Mask icon. In the Input Shadow field, type in 98, and in the input midtones, type in 0.43. Next, we'll make our overall image brighter by clicking the adjustment layer icon and clicking levels again. This time, we won't clip it because we want it to affect all the layers in the layers panel. In the input highlight field, type in 154. The last step is to add flames. As I mentioned at the beginning of this tutorial, we'll be using the flame filter, which was first introduced in version CC 2014.2. Next, we'll group all the layers that comprise our text into a folder. With the top adjustment layer still active, shift-click your text and place all the active layers into a folder. Name it Text. We'll make a new layer below the active layer by control-clicking or command-clicking the new layer icon. Name it Flames. Open your pen tool. I did an in-depth tutorial on the pen tool, including how to make paths with it. If you're not familiar with using the pen tool, watch that tutorial. I provided its link as well. Choose Path. On earlier versions of Photoshop, the path icon is here. We'll be drawing paths for each flame. Draw the path for your first flame. Go to Filter, Render, and Flame. For the flame type, I'll be using one flame along path since I prefer this flame type for this project. I'll make the width 48. Since I want to use the normal default flame colors, I won't be customizing them. For the quality, I'll choose Fine, but know that the higher the quality, the longer it'll take to render. Don't be concerned if the flame isn't the exact shape, nor in the position you'd like. We'll adjust it later. To make the next flame, make a new layer, and open your Paths panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Paths. Press the Delete key on your keyboard to delete the path. Open back the Layers panel, and draw another path along an edge of your text. Press Ctrl or Command F to repeat the flame filter for this path. Continue these steps until you've surrounded most of your text with flames. Make sure you delete the last work path, and then group all the flame layers into a folder. Name it Flames. Open the folder. To reposition and/or reshape each flame without having to locate it in the folder, open your Move tool and check Auto Select. When you click on a flame, it activates it in your Layers panel. Open your Transform tool and at the top, click the Warp icon. Drag the control points or a segment of the bounding box or an area within the mesh to warp the flame. Then press Enter or Return. Click on another flame to activate it and repeat the steps. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.